Okay, so I want to do some more complex examples. Oh, the chain rule, product rule, quotient rule. So a couple here with kind of, here we'll just do polynomials. So, and these will just be examples. So if I have, oops, I probably need a f of x in here. If f of x, and I have this function, x squared plus 3 cubed, 2x minus 1 to the 5th. And I want to find the derivative. I have a whole bunch of stuff going on, and one of the first steps in these problems is to figure out how to break them down. So once you learn these tools, the key becomes being able to break down the problem into specific pieces and then put it back together. So here, one of the first structures that I see is this here that's cubed, and then this separate one here that's to the fifth. And that definitely reminds me of this chain rule, right? But normally in the chain rule, I just have one of these that looks like that. And so the idea that I identify two also leads me to just think, okay, well, I have kind of these two pieces. And in between these two pieces, really right here, is a multiplication. So this should really be a product rule. Where I have this first piece, x squared plus 3 cubed, maybe I'll call that u, and the second piece, 2x minus 1 to the 5th, and I'll call that v. Now, to find the derivative of u, I have to use the chain rule. So here, so in the product rule, do you remember u, v? Well, this is one of the forms. Derivative of u, v is u prime v plus v prime u. Okay, or also the derivative of f g is f prime g plus g prime f. Okay. So I need to find the derivative of u in order to use the product rule. And to find the derivative of u now I've broken it down into this smaller piece, and I say, okay, now this is my chain rule. I'll go ahead and use the chain rule. U prime is 3 x squared plus 3. I remove 1, 2, and then I have to multiply by the derivative of the inside, which is 2x. Okay, then v prime, same thing, 5 out front from this exponent, 2x minus 1, subtract 1 from the exponent, and multiply by the derivative of the inside, which is just 2. And I'll simplify these. I'll combine this 2 and 2x and 3, so I'll get 6x, x squared plus 3 squared, and v prime here is 10 times 2x minus 1 to the 4th. Okay, and now I have broken it down. So this process of what can I recognize here? What do I know how to do? What looks familiar? And then how does that break apart to pieces that I solidly know how to do? And then how do I put that back together? So this one is uv prime plus vv u prime. So f prime is that. So I'll put these pieces back together. So u is x squared plus 3 cubed. Oh, cubed it is. V prime is 10 times 2x minus 1 to the 4th. And then plus, so I'm doing uv prime plus v, 2x minus 1 to the 5th. Is v, and u prime is 6x, x squared plus 3 squared. Okay. Now, at no point can I combine any of this stuff, right? This 3 in the exponent prevents me from multiplying this by the 10, and the 4 here also prevents that multiplication. Same thing over in the second piece. But there's a lot of pieces that are the same. For example, I have repeated this x squared plus 3 piece there and there. Okay, so that can be factored out as a common factor to both of these big things. So let's say I'll factor out, so the biggest one that's in both pieces is squared. So let's say I factor out x squared plus 3 squared. And then that leaves me with, in this first piece, I still have an x squared plus 3 left. I still have a 10. And I still have this 2x minus 1 to the 4th. Whoops. Plus, and then there's my x squared. I got rid of all the x squareds plus 3, so I get 2x minus 1 to the 5th times 6x in this second piece. Okay? And now, when I look at this inside, there's another common factor I can factor out, which is this 2x minus 1. It's here and here, and the smallest exponent is to the 4, so I'll factor that out. So now, in addition to this x squared plus 3 squared out front, I'll get a 2x minus 1 to the 4th, and I'm left with x squared plus 3 times 10. Plus 2x minus 1 times 6x. Okay? And now, this stuff that's inside kind of this bracket can be combined and simplified. You might factor out a 2 there. I'm not sure that that makes your life simpler. But so inside here, I get 10x squared plus 30 plus 12x minus 6. Oh, it's 12x squared. 2x times 6x minus 6x. And then I'll just combine like terms. And then this will be fully factored, I think. Let's see. 10x squared plus 12x squared is 22x squared minus 6x plus 30. And I guess you can see if that's factorable. I doubt that it will be, but this is in pretty simplified form. I would not try to combine anything else. I would probably leave it like this. Okay? Let me do one more. Example. Where did that example go? Oh, I see it. let's do f of x is equal to 2x over x squared plus 3 to the 4th power. Okay? And so the main thing, okay, so the first thing I see in this problem is this big division sign. And so, to me, that says, and kind of screams, that I need to use the quotient rule. Okay? It's a quotient of two things. Where did this stuff go? What was this, to the 4th? I think I erased some things. So this is the quotient rule. If you like the quotient rule, let's see, it's bottom derivative of the top minus top derivative of the bottom over the bottom squared. That's one version of the quotient rule. One that I like. If you like it in G's and F's, then this is GF prime minus FG prime all over G squared. Okay, but you kind of have to keep that separate from this F that's in the main problem. But so either way, I'm going to call them the top and the bottom. So the top is 2x, and the derivative of the top is 2. Now the bottom is x plus, oh, this was an x squared. Somehow I lost part of this problem. X squared plus 3 to the 4th. Did you guys see that happen? I don't know where it went. And so here, now I have to use the chain rule to do this derivative in this piece. So I get 4x squared plus 3 cubed times 2x. I'm going to simplify this one more time and get 8x squared plus 3 cubed. And then I'm going to put it back together. So this breaking down and then putting it back together. So f prime, the bottom, x squared plus 3 to the 4th, times the derivative of the top, which is just 2, minus 2x times the bottom, our derivative of the bottom, which is 8x, x squared plus 3 cubed, all over, and then an x squared plus 3 to the 4th, and then that's all squared. I think that's what I get. Now this should simplify. F prime is, and again, I can factor out this x squared plus 3. So I'll factor out an x squared plus 3 cubed. What's left is x squared plus 3 times 2 in this first piece, minus 2x and 8x in this second piece. And then here in the denominator, it's x squared plus 3, and 4 raised to the second power is 8. So these will cancel here. 3 of these will cancel here, and we'll be left with 5. I think, one more line. F prime is, all of this cancels, because all 3 of these cancel. So here, and I'll multiply this, 2x squared plus 6. Minus 16x squared. I take it back. I have one more line after this. X squared plus 3 to the 5th. And that's all equal to negative 14x squared plus 6 over x squared plus 3 to the 5th. And that should be a final answer. Okay, let me know if you have questions.